Hi everyone, it's me again, Dr. Gator Bredovitas, and 90% of those who guessed what my next topic will be got it right. So we're gonna talk about sunscreens. There's so many things I want to say about sunscreens. There's so much to cover. So I've decided to make this into a two-part series. The first part, tackling the more technical side of it, defining terms, what UVA is, UVB, SPF, etc. While part two will be more on the practical side of things. How to use sunscreens, how to apply them, and how to choose the right products for your skin type. So for those of you who are already using sunscreens and are reapplying every 2 to 3 hours, well, good for you. But for those who are not, maybe I can convince you to start incorporating sunscreen use into your daily regimen after you watch this two-part series on sunscreens. Let me first give you a brief history on sunscreen use. In ancient Egypt, having fair skin was deemed attractive and desirable. So without really knowing how the sun's rays can actually damage the skin, Egyptians started using ingredients such as jasmine, lupin, and rice bran extracts to protect their skin and repair it from sun damage and even to lighten it. And it's not just the Egyptians. The ancient Greeks also used olive oil, and some Native Americans used pine needles to soothe sunburns. So during that time, they're already aware of what the sun can do to the skin, and that the skin actually needed protection from the UV rays. Now, it might come as a surprise to some of you, because ako din nagulat ako, that sunscreen use and development of sunscreen formulations only started in the 1930s and 1940s. And it was only in the late 1970s, 1978 to be exact, that the US FDA started regulating sunscreens as a drug. Why do we have to apply sunscreen? And why do we need to protect ourselves from UV radiation? Prolonged exposure to UV radiation, especially between 10 a.m. to 3 p.m., puts us at risk for developing skin cancers and also can lead to photoaging, what we see as wrinkles, pigment alteration, and broken capillaries. I say UV radiation and not just exposure from the sun, kasi even on cloudy days or pag overcast, we still get exposed to UV radiation. Now, there are two types of UV radiation coming from the sun that are primarily responsible for causing skin damage, UVA and UVB. Now, what is the difference between UVA and UVB? It's actually pretty easy to remember. UVA causes aging and therefore is responsible for the formation of wrinkles, age spots. They can penetrate window glass and go deeper into our skin. On the other hand, UVB naman causes burning. So it's very easy to remember. A for aging, B for burning. So ito yung nagkakos ng darkening of the skin and sunburn. UVB rays are shorter and they cannot penetrate window glass. What is the first thing that anyone looks at when buying sunscreens? More than 50% will look at SPF. But what exactly is SPF? SPF, or sun protection factor, measures the protection that the sunscreen gives us against UVB. An SPF of at least 30 is what I and most dermatologists recommend, because this prevents 97% of the UV rays from reaching our skin. This percentage increases as the SPF number goes up. For example, pag SPF 50, it blocks 98%. But you have to remember that no sunscreen blocks 100% of UV rays. And while higher SPFs suggest longer protection from the sun, all of them, be it SPF 30 or 50 or even 110, stay on our skin about the same amount of time, which on average is 2 hours. Did you know that African Americans have a natural protection against UVB? It is said that their melanin in their skin provides an SPF of around 13 to 16. This is why African Americans are noted to age more slowly than Caucasians. That said, no one is safe from the damaging rays of the sun. lahat tayo, light skin, medium skin, brown skin, dark skin, are all encouraged to use sunscreen because skin cancer can actually happen to anyone. So now, if SPF measures protection from UVB, what about for UVA? There is no officially or globally recognized measurement for UVA protection as of yet. What we suggest is that when buying sunscreens, look for the words broad spectrum or multi-spectrum on the labels. However, in some countries, they use the PA rating system as a measurement of protection against UVA. This was invented by the Japanese and it ranges from +1 to +4. But if you're not sure and you can't seem to find the words broad spectrum or there's no PA rating, just look for two ingredients that are proven to have protection against UVA: avobenzone and zinc oxide. Now let's move on to sunscreen ingredients. I'm sure you've heard about physical sunscreens or chemical sunscreens, but what are they and what differences do they have? Physical or inorganic sunscreens, there are actually only two. Zinc oxide and titanium dioxide creates a barrier protection on top of your skin, and they either reflect or scatter the UVAs away from your skin or absorbs them. More recent studies show that physical sunscreens actually work by absorbing about 90 to 95% of the sun's rays. Chemical or organic sunscreens, on the other hand, are everything else other than zinc oxide and titanium dioxide. Chemical sunscreens need a few minutes after application on your skin to work because instead of forming a barrier protection, they cause a chemical reaction that converts UV rays to heat so that they don't damage the skin. And finally, how much sunscreen should we apply? Applying the right amount of sunscreen is key. It doesn't matter how great your product is, how high your SPF is, if you don't apply enough on your skin, it really won't do its job. And a lot of people actually don't put enough. If you Google it, you will find that you should be applying 2 grams of sunscreen for every 2 centimeters square of your skin. Now, that roughly translates to about a third of a teaspoon for your entire face. But iba-iba naman tayo ng size ng face. So what I tell my patients is that apply just enough that you know the sunscreen is on your face, but not too thick that it feels uncomfortable and greasy. For women, madali lang yan eh. Kasi ako, I like to layer. I have a moisturizer with SPF, I have a primer with SPF, and then I have my sunscreen, and then I have a foundation that has SPF. And in the middle of the day when I have to retouch, I have a compact with SPF. For men, it might be a little more challenging, but newer formulations and newer technologies will give you sunscreens that are not greasy, provides adequate protection, and is easy to reapply. Sunscreen should be applied generously on all exposed areas of the body 15 to 30 minutes prior to sun exposure and should be reapplied every 2 to 3 hours or less if you're swimming or sweating or engaged in sports activities. Do not forget to apply sunscreens to areas like your ears, your lips, and even the scalp on those with already thinning hair. Now, to summarize part 1 of the sunscreen series, look for sunscreens that contain at least an SPF of 30, is broad spectrum or has a PA rating of at least +2, and is water resistant. Apply the right amount of sunscreen on all exposed areas of the skin, including your ears, your lips, and your scalp, and reapply as needed between 10 a.m. to 3 p.m. And finally, sunscreen is not the only way you can protect yourself from the harmful UV rays of the sun. You can also seek shade, wear protective clothing, or put on a hat or use an umbrella. So this ends part 1 of the sunscreen series. Please try to catch part 2, which will be more on the practical side of things, how to properly apply sunscreens, what sunscreens are there for your skin type, what formulations in the market are available, and also I will try to answer some common questions that you might have regarding sunscreen use. But before you go, please don't forget to click the like and the subscribe button. Thank you for watching. I will see you in part 2. Bye.